Hey, good morning. Grade 10 review here. I think I might have done like 10 videos all about this. They just keep getting better and better. The Pythagorean theorem, it's the magic of the right triangle. This is fundamental, like fundamental. This is critical. This is a must know. You will be using this in every math unit for the rest of the year. This is a grade 10 review. Actually, it's grades well before that. However, let's just get into this. Here we go. All right, so, hey, Mr. P was a teacher, well, sort of a philosopher. Back in those days, teachers were philosophers and, thinkers. And he was probably even a gangster. He had some, he had some interesting rules amongst his students, his disciples, and he even drowned one of them for disagreeing with him. So never disagree with your teacher. All right, anyway, we've known this law for at least, well, even before him, we knew the law. He's the guy that kind of promoted it. All right, so it's 2,500 years old, at least, this law. So maybe we can figure it out. Here it is right here. You got it? There. Lesson's done. See, I just showed you. There is the law. It's right there. If you just look at that diagram and digest it, then you just completely understood his idea. It's a pretty simple idea. Shall I explain it some more? If you want to know more explanation, then just keep going. Otherwise, this diagram pretty much sums it up. Okay, I'll keep going then. All right. There's what he said. The sum of the squares on the two short sides of a right triangle equals the square on the long side. Say this to yourself 10 times. Say it out loud, even, not on the bus. I'm serious. Back in the old days, we actually had to say things out loud in class together, and we had to write them down on the blackboard 50 times. I'm not joking. That is how you learn. Repetition is a wonderful way to learn. Say it over and over 10 times. Oh, well, there's the idea right there. Look, I love pictures. Pictures are a way better thing than silly words. Are you ready? Did you say it 10 times? Did you write it down on a piece of paper 10 times? If you didn't, then evidently you're not too interested in learning this. Here we go. So here's the idea. I'll explain it a little more if you didn't understand that first diagram. Here's a right triangle. It has a 90-degree corner, right? If you took out a, it's got a square corner, put it that way. This rule, this law, only works for triangles with a square corner. Fortunately, every shape in the universe can be made up of triangles with square corners. All right, so if you got a, if I made a square on this side, right, if this side of the triangle is 3, then obviously a square would have to be 3 long that way, and there'd be 3 rows of 3, which is what we call 3, and we squirt that 2 in the corner. That's called a square, so 3 squared, and that's 9. I hope you know 3 times 3 is 9. So there we go. There'd be 9 beads or tiles or whatever in that square, depending on your culture. And let's see, if this side of the triangle was 4, then obviously the left side there would be 4. Otherwise, it wouldn't be a square. And there would be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. How many? 4 rows of 4 is 16. There'd be 16 beads or tiles or whatever in there. 16. There'd be 16. Now here comes the magic. Here comes the magic. 16 plus 9 is 25. Woohoo! There, we're done. If you take the square on this side and add it to the square on this side, the sum of the squares on the two short sides, the sum of the squares on the two short sides will equal the square on the longest side. What does all that mean? Well, here. Well, we already said we got to have 25 beads or tiles or whatever your culture used there, right? Here we go. Watch this. All right, so there's 25, and if I just toggle it here and grab it, and I can take it like that, and I can go like that, and son of a gun, Looky, looky. All right, look, it's going to fit right there. Isn't that awesome? It does fit. 5 by 5 is 25. I hope you know that 5 times 5 is 25. Hey, so if you've got a 3 here and a 4 here, and you have it's a right triangle with a square corner, this side here has to be exactly 5. There's no bout about it. That's it. The sum of the squares on the two short sides of a right triangle equals the square on the long side. Say that to yourself 10 more times. Write it down 20 times. There. Are you done? Oh, you want some examples, do you? Okay. Let's try this one. I'll just race through these very quickly. Determine length X. You can always pause this. Here we go. And they're off. Notice I didn't draw proper squares. I'm just kind of sketching them here. I'm not being exact. You're allowed to sketch things. You don't have to draw everything out perfectly with squares. How did I know that 13 times 13 is 169? We unsquared. Find that button on your calculator. Somewhere on your calculator, you got a button that looks like that. It's called the square root. In other words, it unsquares something. So the unsquare of 169 is 13, because 13 times 13 is 169. So you're just unsquaring. I call it the unsquare button. It's called the square root button. Let's try a couple more here. Here's two more to try. Pause these if you want. I'm just going to race through them. Notice I like it when you round the answer to the nearest 0.01. So 4.47. Let's do this one. Did you pause it? That'd be 4.24 units long. And it has to be, obviously, since that's the longest side, that's the hypotenuse. Since that is the longest side, it has to be longer than either of the other two sides. And after a while, you just quit sketching stuff all the time. There's nothing wrong with sketching it than counting the squares and the beads and the tiles on each edge of your triangle. I would give you full marks for that. However, after a while, you start to abbreviate things and make it a little quicker with symbols. So, if you say that the long side squared equals the sum of the squares of the shorter two sides, provided you call A a short side and B a short side, or whatever letters you want, as long as the long side, the hypotenuse, all by itself is squared, it equals the sum of the squares of the shorter two sides. Make sure you understand the symbols in any formula. A formula has a meaning. It represents an idea. By the way, the long side, the longest side of a right triangle, it's called its hypotenuse. Look, it's got the word hypo. Hypo as in extra cold, like hypothermia. There you go. So now you know the rules. There's the formula. I hope you've been saying this to yourself over and over. I hope you write it down 20 times. Don't just look at it. Looking at it is not learning. You have to write it down many times. How about one more? Pause and do. Okay, so pause. There's my answer. What'd you get? Did you get the same thing? So this hypotenuse side, the side across from the square corner, the longest side, is 10.82. Obviously, it's got to be longer than 9. You can almost eyeball it, too, if it's drawn nicely. How about another one? Well, now there's something to think about here. Notice what I did here. I got a bit sneaky. This time I told you what the long side was. You didn't have to figure out what the long side was because I told you what the long side was. On this triangle, I told you the long side and I told you a short side, and you have to figure out the other short side. Remembering also that the square on the short side plus the square on the short side equals the square on the long side. How long is side B? The law still works. So what number goes there? What number added to 64 gives you 100? 36. So you know there's 36 beads in there, and you know that 6 times 6 is 36. So you can still use the symbols too. You can still use the equation. You write down the formula. Then you plug in the numbers. 10 squared, 8 squared, plus mystery squared. You know that 10 squared is 100. You know that 8 squared is 64. Put it on your plastic brain if you don't have it memorized. And you know that's got to be added to some other number. So guess what? That number there has to be a 36, because 64 plus 36 gives you 100. A little subtracting would tell you that. Which means the B is 6. There you go. That's exactly 6 right there. 6. 6 is the answer. Tons more practice. Here you go. I'm just going to race through these. Pause all of these. Pause. Notice I give you the answers here. Did you get it? Next bunch of practice problems. Did you get them? Here's the next bunch of practice problems. Ooh, word problems. I love these. Did you get them? Here comes the answers. And don't forget, sometimes you can eyeball the answer too, eh? If that's a 7 and that kind of looks about right as a 5, then you could kind of eyeball this and go, well, it's got to be longer than 7, so it's got to be shorter than 12, so it's somewhere between 7 and 12, so if you kind of dropped it down here, you'd go, oh, it looks like it might be about 9 or so, and then when you get 8.6, you're not surprised. Whoops. Oh, no, I showed you the answers. Oh, man, pause and do. Oh, darn, I showed you the answers. And I think I got one more here. Stand by. There you go. So that should pretty much covers all of Pythagoras in 14 minutes. There. You got the Mr. P down. Mr. Pythagoras, the magic of the right triangle. It's critical. You must know this. There it is right there. Complete.